We prepare this final Sunday of Advent with the knowledge that God will be with us soon. We do so not through the faith of Mary, we do so not with another story of what is to come, but through an acceptance in faith by Joseph. Joseph does not expect what is coming. Not that Mary much expected it either, but for Joseph, his faith has to be placed in both what Mary has told him and what is revealed to him in today's gospel reading. For Mary, her complete giving of herself in faith to God to be the vessel through which the Christ child would enter into this creation is of a magnitude beyond what others have been asked before or will be asked again. She has to give her physical being over to the will of God and risk everything, including losing Joseph, losing her place in her community, to answer the call that has been given to her. Joseph then does the reasonable thing when he learns about this unexpected pregnancy. He arranges in quiet for their engagement to go away, so that he will not be tied to this event, but also to protect Mary as much as he can. And God intervenes again. God calls Joseph to accept a call as well, to live into his faith and know that this is the time that the prophets have been pointing towards, to know that what is happening in this moment goes beyond whatever challenges may be presented to them in staying together, to see it through to this birth, to raise this child as their own, to know that Emmanuel is coming. And Joseph is called into all of this with the understanding that his role in this story is protecting Mary and making sure that this child will be protected as well. Joseph does not play a large or at least visible part in this story once we push beyond the Christmas season. But it's in this beginning, this initial arrival of God being with us in the form of this child, that Joseph is tasked with a role, a call to that is honored in his sainthood, and is honored in his presence on mantles and shelves all around the world in the nativity sets that we all have. Joseph lives into this call today because of the promise that has come from the prophet. Joseph lives into this call today because God shows him that growing in Mary is the one whom the prophet spoke of when they said, "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel." We are called today to know that Emmanuel is coming to be with us as well, here and now. Throughout the season of Advent, we have used the hymn, O Come Emmanuel, as our gospel processional. This hymn speaks to our journey through the season of Advent as we prepare and make straight the path. This hymn illustrates to us the reality what it truly means to name this one child Emmanuel, and to know that God is with us. We say today, O come, desire of nations, bind in one the hearts of all mankind, bid thou our sad divisions cease, and be thyself our King of peace. I've been praying every day this particular season of Advent that for that very reality made true. It's been a struggle for me to fully embrace the coming joy of the Christ child, of God being with us, when we as a community have been forced to fight for our most vulnerable neighbors so they're not thrown into the county dump. It's been a struggle to fully embrace the coming joy of the Christ child, of God being with us, when we as a community have had to implore our elected leadership to lead our community rather than bow under the pressure of a vocal minority that really only seems to exist on social media, which I think says something about the ills of social media as much as it does listening to the anger on it. Okay. This is a vocal minority that believes our fellow brothers and sisters in creation do not deserve compassion and concern and care to meet them where they are at today, believing instead that somehow someone without food, a secure shelter, a place to use the bathroom that isn't outdoors, a humiliating experience when it isn't a chosen one, not to mention a place to bathe on a regular basis, can simply choose to get and secure a job that pays them enough to save the first back and security deposit and find an apartment that will rent to them with no recent rental history in a rental market that is ultra competitive, with ever escalating prices and no new viable units being created for low income folks. I tend to get a little angry when I see those comments. And then I get sad. I get sad because my anger towards their ignorance doesn't solve anything. I get sad because this ignorance exists. And I get sad because we call out to Emmanuel to bind in one the heart of all mankind, and yet, here we are. Once I get over being sad, I am encouraged. I'm encouraged by those who have taken the opportunity to learn who our homeless neighbors actually are, and have changed their opinions because their hearts have been changed. It's hard not to when the people you meet at a severe weather shelter are predominantly older, meaning disabled either physically or mentally, who are so grateful for just a bite to eat and a warm place to sleep. And I'm also encouraged because I have faith. I have faith that Joseph expresses today. The faith that what God calls us to is where we are supposed to be. The faith that when God calls to us, we are given all that we need to be successful in that role. Sometimes we may play just a part in a larger role. And sometimes we may be called into something wholly unexpected and extremely demanding. I mean, planning to be a parent is hard enough. I can only imagine where Mary and Joseph are at today. Wherever we are called, we answer that call because of our faith. And because of the knowledge that we have in our tradition that points us to the work that God has done, is doing, and will do in time still to come. After we've sung our verse appointed for today, as we sang in our opening hymn, we finish as we do each verse of this hymn with the following refrain: Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice. Our faith calls us to rejoice in the promise of Emmanuel. Emmanuel has not yet arrived. We're patiently awaiting his arrival. We have prepared for his arrival. And so we sing, rejoice, rejoice, because Emmanuel is coming. Because we know in our faith that what God has promised through the prophets will be realized. And if we cheat just a little ahead, we know in Christ those promises have been realized. So my hope for today and tomorrow, this liminal space we still occupy, still in preparation and anticipation, is that we live into the faith that Joseph demonstrates today. My hope for today and tomorrow is that the pending arrival of Emmanuel will begin to turn the hearts of those who would divide and harm. My hope for today and tomorrow is that preparing for Christmas is more than just finishing shopping and making food and cleaning the house and doing whatever last-minute items are on the checklist for our Christmas celebration. But rather, preparing for Christmas is an expression of the reality of our faith. The joy that we have in the coming of our Lord. The pure sense that in this baby child is the hope of our faith, and the realization of what we are called to believe and how we're called to live into that belief. Rejoice, rejoice, we cry out today. Emmanuel shall come, is coming, has come. And today we prepare for that coming once more and forever. Amen.